Hello, everybody, and welcome to Hurricane Game Day. I'm your host, Joe Zagacki, coming to you from Alex Rodriguez Park. We're in the visitor's dugout, and this week, visiting Alex Rodriguez Park will be the North Carolina Tar Heels, ranked third in the country. They lead the University of Miami by one game in the Coastal Division. Now, last week, the Hurricanes were on the road against Clemson, a hard-fought series. The Canes dropped 2 out of 3.
And I'm going to tell you, it's amazing. You can win the first two games and lose the last game, and you feel awful. Not that you feel great when you win the last game, but at least you feel a little better walking out there with a win. It's a tough place to play. We battled all weekend. All three games were very, very close. And we got to continue to get better. Bottom, we shot ourselves in the foot on defense and base running. We didn't swing the bat, but we really pitched well. And it's, you know, a lot of it's about pitching.
As I mentioned earlier, we are in the visitor's dugout, and this weekend it will be occupied by North Carolina. Their calling card is pitching, and this year is no different as they lead the conference in team ERA.
Well, Carolina's got a, you know, an outstanding club, no question, and they always play well. They get the lowest ERA in the conference, and they're going to go right after us. So we're going to have to pitch. We're going to have to pitch and play good defense and get some timely hitting. You've heard that before, I know.
I expect a well-disciplined team, a team that doesn't make many mistakes, and a team that capitalizes on mistakes that the opponent makes. So we got to come prepared, and we got to limit our mistakes, for sure.
It's huge. We lost 2 of 3 against Clemson, so we have to go into this North Carolina series with full force and, you know, try to sweep or take 2 of 3.
Well, they're a team that puts a lot of pressure on you. You know, they're very well coached. Fundamentally sound, and they don't strike out a lot, put the ball in play. So you got to make pitches, and you know, 1 through 9, you can't relax. You got to stay mentally focused and continue to pitch.
Still to come here on Hurricane Game Day, talking University of Miami baseball. We'll sit down with head coach Jim Morris, pitching coach J.D. Arteaga, and outfielder Chance Mack. All of that and more right here on CSS.
Well, I think a lot of programs copied the University of Miami, and I got to tell you, I copied it at Georgia Tech. I went so far as to bring our people down here and sit down with Coach Frazier so Coach Frazier would explain to our guys what he was trying to do and what he had done, and then we tried to duplicate that at Georgia Tech.
You know, what's amazing with him is his first go around here, he had it all figured out, you know, and he was very successful as a high school pitcher and very successful here his first, you know, 4 years.
Hurricane Game Day is brought to you by the Florida Fan Game. Think the Canes are Florida's number one fans? Prove it at facebook.com/sharealittlesunshine. We'll be right back. Welcome to Hurricane Game Day with University of Miami head coach Jim Morris. And this weekend, the Hurricanes home against North Carolina here at Alex Rodriguez Park. So a great time to come out and see University of Miami baseball. Coach, a week ago you went to Clemson, three hard-fought games. I thought you pitched extremely well.
We did pitch good. I mean, all three starters threw very well, and we were in all three games. And unfortunately, we lost the first two. We could have won them, but we made some mistakes defensively, and we shot ourselves in the foot base running a couple times too. And we could have won. We didn't swing the bat well enough. We got to do all those things. And if you have low-scoring games against good people on the road, tough parks, you got to do them all to win, and we didn't do it. We did that on Sunday. We did a much better job being able to get a win.
You mentioned on the road, and I thought Clemson showed how healthy college baseball is. For their three games there, for your three games there, they had over 12,000 for the three games. The University of Miami always brings a lot of fans to the ballpark.
You know, you're right, Joe. They have a good crowd. But I got to tell you, it's the least amount of fans that Miami, if you look this up, it's the least amount of fans ever at Clemson for a Miami series. I didn't think the crowd was quite as intimidating as they normally were. The weather was a little shaky on Friday night. I thought maybe that was the case, but really, they're on their umpires worse than they are on us. I mean, it's pretty crazy. Every pitch for them is a strike, and every pitch we throw is a ball.
Yeah, that's true. They were on the umps quite a bit. Offensively, you mentioned you were challenged there in the first two games. Just couldn't get the key hit. But the third game, guys like Dale Carey came through. Steven Perez had a big triple in the third game for you. So I think once Carey kind of carried that burden for you, then it seemed to – team seemed to relax.
You're right. I mean, Dale's, it was a big hit, but it was a two-out hit, too, with second, third, and that was huge. And of course, Steven Perez to hit the ball off the wall, first pitch, off for closures, 95-96, got good stuff. So those were big, and we played good defense that last day, and I thought we did a better job playing the entire game.
You've moved Steven Perez back to shortstop. You turned a couple of double plays in the final game of the series. How much will it help if Steven can continue to play it short?
Well, I think he can. Actually, he was released to play short a couple weeks before I started playing him at short, and I was kind of cautious with it which he wanted to play short, and he was mad at me because he wasn't playing short, really. He wanted to play, and I just wanted to make sure he's okay because we want him for the remainder of the season. I think he'll be fine, and I mean, Steve's a very good infielder. He's got really good instincts.
No, you are. It is coming together for you up the middle. O'Brien, I know he was the DH last week, but behind the plate, you're pretty solid there. Steven, solid at shortstop. Dale Carey now getting a really good grasp of center field, had another great play in the outfield.
He did. I mean, Dale played good, and he's a good outfielder. And, of course, as you say, O'Brien. But I got to tell you, Garrett Kennedy behind the plate's a very good receiver. He's a freshman, and he's going along, you know, learning. But he's a good receiver, and we expect to have O'Brien back in the very near future.
Okay, this weekend, Carolina comes here. They're ranked third in the country. You've got a good pitching staff, and they're always loaded in the pitching department.
Right, they are. They've got a great pitching staff, so it's going to be a challenge for us hitting-wise, and the fact that our pitchers have got to pitch well. We're putting a lot of pressure on our pitchers, it seems like, every game to pitch every inning and give up no runs. So it'd be nice to score a few runs.
You got the best of them last year. You beat them in a doubleheader up there, and you beat them in the ACC tournament.
Right. Well, they were down a little bit last year. Still a good club, and they're always good. I mean, there are certain teams in this conference, as you know, they're going to always be good. Sometimes they're better than other years, but they're always going to be good.
You know, I was thinking about it because teams like Carolina have come on, and Clemson, they've come on through the years. They all have nice ballparks now. And I keep thinking to myself, well, Miami's in the conference, but Miami's also to blame. Because they looked at Miami, looked at your program, and said, if they're doing that, maybe we can do it.
Well, I think a lot of programs copied the University of Miami, and I got to tell you, I copied it at Georgia Tech. I went so far as to bring our people down here and sit down with Coach Frazier so Coach Frazier would explain to our guys what he was trying to do and what he had done, and then we tried to duplicate that at Georgia Tech, and they've done a pretty good job of doing that.
All right, in the rankings in the RPI this week, you're in the top 20. I know you want to go higher, because the goal always is to get the regional and a super regional.
You're right. I mean, our RPI right now is 12, and we dropped from 8 to 12, so we need to be in that top 8. And the RPI, we need to be in the top 8 in the rankings, and that's our goal, and that will kind of set you up for the NCAA tournament.
Erickson will go for you this weekend and pitch his heart out the other day against Clemson.
He pitched well enough to win. That might be as good as he's pitched since he's been here. I'm counting not just this year, but his entire career. He pitched great, really located. He missed on a couple pitches, but he pitched very well. If we played good defense, he would have got a W there.
Doesn't really matter who you're playing. You know, a team like Maryland will beat you if you don't show up that day. So it's a great challenge every week, and it gets you ready for the postseason.
Hurricane Game Day is brought to you by the Florida Fan Game. Think the Canes are Florida's number one fans? Prove it at facebook.com/share a little sunshine.